Hi there, my name is Sophie Walker and welcome to the Golfalot review on the new Titleist Tour Speed golf balls. Now, Titleist are the number one ball in golf, but they are calling out other manufacturers and they're saying that this ball is faster than theirs. So what am I going to do today? I'm going to try it out and compare them all. So not only have Titleist called manufacturers out, they've actually named the golf ball that they think theirs is faster than. So we've got the Schrixen Z Star, the Callaway Chrome Soft and the TaylorMade Tour Response. I'm on the 13th hole at Denton Golf Club, it's a par 3 and I'm going to compare all four of them. This isn't a trick shot, this is just rapid fire testing. Schrixen Z Star, pin high, felt nice. Callaway Chrome Soft. That one felt slightly softer. TaylorMade Tour Response. Now for the Titleist. Is it gonna be faster? Let's go and have a look. Come up to the green. As you can see, much of a muchness in terms of distance. The ones to the left went slightly further. Maybe a touch of pull. All of them are stopping and dropping. What I would say is off the tee, I felt the Chrome Soft was slightly softer than the Titleist, but I aren't noting too much difference at the moment. Titleist are also claiming outstanding feel around the greens. Now I've got a 90 foot chip shot, it's down the hill. I think this is the best way to test balls around the green because the feel is most important for these type of golf shots. So I'm going to stick with the Schrixen first. That felt reasonably hard off the face. Back to the Callaway Chrome Soft. Softer. TaylorMade Response. Oh, go on then. I would say the TaylorMade and the Callaway felt very similar. Sit. Yeah, you can separate them. The last three were definitely softer and better feel than that first Schrixen for me. So yes, absolutely soft feel, but is it better than the other two? I'm not sure yet. Looks wise, it's definitely a duller finish. I think it cheapens it, in all honesty. Now, I normally use the Pro V1X in our testings. If you can see that, there is a duller finish to it, and the Titleist logo is slightly different. I'm not a huge fan of that, it does put me off. There is an alignment aid, but we'll look at that when we're going to start doing some putts. But what I want to know is, driver, am I going to lose any distance or gain any distance with this ball against the Pro VX? What I did like actually about that ball was the alignment aid is good for your driver. So that's something which is a bonus. Pro VX. Now to the naked eye that one looked further. I want to go and have a look. Right, looks can be deceiving. Maybe I wanted the Pro V1X to go a bit further. And it did, by 2 feet. Now, that's £40 a dozen for that golf ball, and that golf ball is £50 a dozen. And there's only a couple of feet in it. So that was a really good test for me to do it out on the golf course. Surprised me. Now let's talk technology. I'm just gonna read the back of the box for you. The new Titleist Tour Speed is a three-piece thermoplastic urethane covered golf ball designed to deliver consistent category-leading performance. Pro proven through extensive testing with amateurs. So that's cool. They're not just giving it to the tour pros, they're giving it to the people they want to use it. Tour Speed provides a unique combination of exceptional distance in the long game and precision short game scoring control. Speed meets performance in the new Titleist Tour Speed. Tour Speed player benefits, exceptional distance, penetrating flight on long game shots, precision scoring control and soft feel. Wow, that's a lot of technology and a lot of promises. 16th hole at Denton Golf Club. I'm going to play an entire hole with the new Tour Speed Titleist golf balls. I won't be losing one straight down the middle. 190 to the pin. Feeling much difference at the minute between that and a premium ball. I don't think I will do in my long game, just in the short game. Come on then, chip her in. Oh, move. Oh. Now the Tour Speed ball does have an alignment aid on it already for you. So it's pretty simple. It's got the arrows across, a reasonably thick line. And what you do is you pick your line for the putt and you either put it on top of the ball or like I do, kind of in line here. I think it's good that they're putting it on for you. I'm all for alignment aids. I'm not the best at a marker pen and a Sharpie, so I don't mind it when the manufacturer does it for you. Try that again. Oh, there you go. I quite like the arrows and the lines. They all kind of blur into one when you look down on it. Feel-wise, it's soft enough, but as you can see, I mean, I've hit a few past the hole. It's quite energetic, I think would be the way to call it. But there's definitely no ting or hardness. Now the shell of this golf ball looks like it should be hard, okay? It doesn't look premium, but the feel of it is definitely better than the look of it, which in my opinion is what you want from a golf ball. So that's my outdoor testing finished. I think if you are a Pro V1 player, but don't want to spend £50 on your golf balls for winter, say, these aren't a bad winter ball. They're not a bad ball in general, in all fairness, but I need to get inside and see if Titleist are doing what they say. Do these golf balls, are these faster golf balls than the other manufacturers that they claim to be? Now I need a track man for that, so I'm gonna head inside to LSH Auto. That's my indoor testing finish. Unfortunately, Titleist, I couldn't get that ball speed any higher with your ball compared to the other three. My club speed increasing was reflected in ball speed increasing, but that was with whatever club and whatever ball I used. They were all so similar in their performance. On the golf course, I felt the Chrome Soft was softer around the greens. It was notably softer. The Shrixon was noticeably firmer as well. But, you know, it was a good golf ball. Like, if you don't want to pay that extra £10-15 more for the Pro V1 or the Pro V1X, and these balls are decent. I quite enjoyed them. I just didn't like the look of them. I don't know why Titleist have cheapened their look with that outer off-colour white shell. Bit of a shame, but give them a go. They're an excellent £10, £15 cheaper golf ball, but they aren't faster than any of the others. So that's my review of the Titleist Tour Speed golf ball. Thank you very much for watching. If you're new to the channel, please click the subscribe button, the like button, and we want your comments below. What golf balls are you playing at the moment? And are you going to have a go at one of these?